Hi, I'm Nathan with Allegiant RV and Trailer. I'm here to show you a couple things today. We're preparing a unit for Winterize. I say preparing because we're doing a Winterize, but we're also preparing to put a cover over top of the trailer, which involves a few other things. The customer does not plan on having their unit plugged in over the winter, so an additional thing that you're not going to see on video, but we will be doing, is we're actually going to be removing the lead acid battery from the tongue in the box that it's in to prevent it from freezing. So we're going to take that out. We're going to give it to the customer so that she can put it inside her house to keep it warm and keep it from freezing. Right now we're working on the Winterize. I just wanted to show you guys a couple things. One thing is this right here. This is what your water heater looks like inside the RV here. This one right here has two valves. You got one right here. This is your hot water outlet. So down here, this is your cold water inlet. So the way your water system works on this is your cold water comes in here and it goes into the tank. And then it heats itself up, and after it's coming out hot, it comes out through here going through your hot water supply. This right here is a bypass hose. For winterizing purposes, what we're going to do is, you notice right now how the handles on both of these is pointed towards the tank? That's indicating the direction that that valve is open to. So what we're going to do, we're going to figure out which way these go. There we go. Now these valves are open, so this water is flowing in the direction of the handle here, so it's coming into the valve, and it's continuing through the bypass, and then back into this line right here. The water heater is now isolated, so we're going to go drain the water heater. We're going to go outside, we're going to drain the water heater. When the water heater is fully drained out, this is a type that has an anode rod in it, so we're going to flush the tank really good, make sure that we get all of the sediment deposits and everything out of it. And then we're going to leave the anode rod not plugged in to the actual tank. We're just going to prop it up to the side. That way, cold air can go in and out. So in the event that there is any water that's still left in the bottom of the tank and it freezes, it has some place to go. You don't ever want to trap water in a cold environment. It causes it to, when it goes from liquid to solid, it expands. When it expands, that's when the damage is caused in the plumbing system. So, go. One other thing I wanted to show you folks, in the event that you do plan on leaving your unit plugged in over the winter, to keep your battery going and everything, keep the outside temperatures in mind. But also make sure that all of your 12-volt stuff inside is turned off if you don't plan on hooking up your battery. So you're going to make sure things like your radio, for example, is turned off all the way. Okay, we're going to try that again because So red light, that's it. Minimal power usage. One of the other things is, right up here on the ceiling, you'll notice there's two green lights on this little line guard plug right here. Now, this right here is your booster for your cable antenna. You want to turn those off so that those green lights are off. So the only parasitic draw that you want on this when you're prepping it for winter is going to be your LP detector. And that's only if you have a battery hooked up or you're plugged in. That should be the only thing that's drawing power other than the minimal usage of your radio here. If you have any questions, our contact information is at the beginning of the video. But if you're in the South Central Washington area and you need some support, you need a technician to come out and take a look at things, give us a call, send us an email. Both of the phone numbers that are listed with our company are both mobile cellular phones. So you can send us texts as well. We'll get back to you as quick as we can. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us.
Thanks, Nathan. We appreciate your help.